Okay, good afternoon to one and all. Today's topic is saline water intrusion in aquifers. Saline water is the most common pollutant in fresh groundwater. Intrusion of saline water occurs where saline water displaces or mixes with fresh water in an aquifer. The phenomena can occur in deep aquifers with the upward advance of saline waters of geological origin, in shallow aquifer from surface waste discharge, and in coastal aquifers from an invasion of seawater. This is the thing of saline water intrusion. So next, occurrence of saline water intrusion. Generally, salt water intrusion into fresh groundwater formation generally results without intents from human activities. Most large sources of fresh groundwater are in close proximity to the sea, to natural bodies of saline groundwater or to salt from effluent waste released by human activities. Here, what are the human activities? The main important here. Generally, groundwater extraction, lowering of groundwater table, a mining of oil and gas, human saline water. Okay, these are the main things. So here, saline water in aquifers may be derived from any several sources. They are encroachment of seawater in coastal aquifer areas, seawater that enter the aquifers during the past geological time, salt in salt domes, thin beds, are disseminated in geological formation. Water concentrated by evaporation in tidal lagoons, playas, or other enclosed areas returned flow to streams from irrigated land. And last one is human saline waste. There are few categories of saline water intrusions. The more responsible is there. Mechanical responsible. They are reduction of reversal groundwater gradients, which permits denser saline water to displace fresh water. This situation commonly occurs in coastal aquifers in hydraulic continuity with the sea when pumping of wells disturb the natural hydrodynamic balances. Destruction of natural barriers that separate fresh and saline waters. An example would be the construction of a coastal drainage canal that enables tidal water to advance inland and to percolate into fresh aquifers. Subsurface disposal of waste saline water, such as disposal wells, landfills, and other waste respiratories. Saline water intrusion is a special category of groundwater pollution. This is the common thing. Okay, so this problem exists in localities of most part of the India, entire east coast and west coast of the regions, because of India have the big length of coastal lines. The ocean islands are completely underlined with the aquifers containing seawater. These are the things. So next point is next one, Ghyben Herzberg relation between fresh and saline water. More than 100 years ago, two groups of investigators working independently along the European coast found that salt water occurred underground, not at sea level, but at a depth below sea level of about 40 times the height of the fresh water above sea level. This distribution was attributed to a hydrostatic equilibrium existing between the two fluids of different densities. The equation derived to explain the phenomena, generally referred to as Ghyben Herzberg relation. Rho S G into H Z, rho F G Z plus H F. Here rho S is the density of saline water and rho F is the density of fresh water. And G is the acceleration of gravity, and HF becomes the elevation of the water table above sea level, and Z it refers to the depth to the fresh and saline water interface below the sea level. So this YouTube illustrated the balance between fresh water and saline water. So in a hydrostatic balance, here the dark black color refers the saline water and dotted line refers the fresh water. This is the interface between the fresh and saline water below the sea level. This is the sea level, okay, surface, and this is the ground level. So this is a groundwater level. So here HF refers to the become the elevation of the water table above sea level. So above sea level, so water table, it refers the HF. Please unmute your volume. You can get the clear voice. So same thing, okay, we have to apply on the present coastal aquifers. This is the ground surface region. Here's the ocean, the seawater, and this is the water table. This is the mean sea level. This line it's indicate the interface between saline water and fresh water. So saline water density is rho S and fresh water density is rho F. So this Z, it refers the interface between the fresh and saline water depth. Okay, this is the, so which is the Ghyben Herzberg relations for typical seawater conditions. Let saline water density is 1.025 gram per centimeter cubed. The fresh water density 1 gram per centimeter cubed. Z is equal to rho F by rho S minus rho F into HF. Then these values, if you implemented, then you can get the Z is equal to 40 HF. Which underline the saline water is in motion with the heads above or below sea level, the result for non-equilibrium condition as a term Z is equal to rho F by rho S minus rho F into H minus rho F by rho S minus rho F into HS. So next topic is shape of the fresh and salt water interface. Recognizing the approximation inherent in the Ghyben Herzberg relation, more exact solution for the shape of the interface have been developed from potential flow theory, resulted by Glover, has the form Z square is equal to 2 rho qx by delta rho into k plus rho q by delta rho into k whole square, where Z and X are shown in figure, and delta rho is equal to rho S minus rho F is the density of the fresh water. K is the hydraulic conductivity of the aquifer, and Q is the fresh water flow per unit length of shoreline. Corresponding shape of the water table is given by HF. The width X0 of the submarine zone through the which fresh water discharges into the sea can be obtained for Z is equal to 0, yielding X0 is equal to rho Q by 2 delta rho into K. So this is the equation. And depth of the interface beneath the shoreline Z0 occurs where the X0, so that Z0 is equal to rho Q by delta Q into K. So this is the figure. Okay, it refers the Z0. So depth interface beneath the shoreline here, and Z the interface line here, the fresh water, okay, so flow towards the shoreline or coastal line. So this is the ocean, okay, this is saline water, this is the exact interface, okay, between the fresh and saline water. This is a groundwater table, this is a ground surface. Next one is the control of saline water intrusion. So there are a few methods is there to controlling the saline water intrusions. In that modification of pumping pattern, artificial recharge, and subsurface barrier, injection barriers, and extraction barriers. These methods for controlling the intrusion vary widely depending on the source of the saline water. The extent of the intrusion is totally depends on the local geology, water use, and economic factors. The first method is a modification of pumping pattern. Changing the location of pumping wells, typically by dispersing them in inland areas, can aid in re-establishing strong seaward hydraulic gradient. Also, reduction pumping of existing wells can produce the same beneficial effect. Artificial recharge. So we are most familiar with this top, artificial recharge, okay, because in EE and geology and groundwater also we discuss a lot about artificial recharge. Here also again we repeated, groundwater levels can be raised and maintained by artificial recharge using surface spreading for continued aquifers and recharge wells for confined aquifers. This is necessity development of supplemental water resources. It's very important for them. And there are few methods is there controlling of seawater intrusions. The source of cause of intrusion. Seawater in coastal aquifers, the control method is modification of pumping pattern, artificial recharge, extraction barriers, injection barriers, submarine subsurface barriers. Upconing cause, the modification of pumping pattern, saline scavenger wells. For oil field drain, elimination of surface disposal injection wells, plugging of abandoned wells, defective wells, casings, plugging faulty wells, surface infiltration cause elimination of source, saline water zones in freshwater aquifers. So relocating design of wells, these are the and subsurface barriers. This is the impermeable subsurface barrier. So it is nearby the coastal they are constructed, and this is the saline groundwater and fresh water. This is the interface line, and this is the ocean. The subsurface barrier, this barrier construction and impermeable materials. The materials are asphalt, cement grout, bentonite, silica gel, calcium, plastics, and these are the main things. And injection barriers. In this method, generally, so recharged wells, we send the water, in these wells. So this water dispersed and it reduces the concentrated saline water. So while increasing of this the injection of fresh water, so it the saline in water, there may be high chances to control. And extraction barriers. This is the last one, extraction barriers. So here, construct the any well nearby the ocean to extract the more volume of water continuously, then it is a high chances to reduce of the saline